It is something we all think about when we step into the ocean. What's in the water? And how close are the sharks? Even though attacks are rare, Volusia County currently holds the title of Shark Bite Capital of the World. West 2 Scott Heidler spoke to shark experts about the science behind these frightening encounters.
Fascinated by sharks from an early age, Toby Daly Engel leads Florida Tech's Shark Conservation Lab.
A leopard shark?
Yeah.
Sees the fear of these majestic fish detached from reality.
Sharks are the ultimate unknown. And when people are afraid of sharks, it's really that unknown that they're afraid of. It's not the reality of a shark encounter, which is astronomically rare. It's the possibility. It's that fear. It's a little bit, I think, why we like scary movies.
And that these apex predators that predate dinosaurs have lived so long because they are extremely cautious about their prey.
So the normal protocol for sharks hunting is to bite the prey and then back off while the prey loses blood and weakens so that the shark can then come in and feed.
And that's one of the main reasons most people bitten by sharks only sustain gashes or cuts on their legs or feet. More than 97% survive.
And so punching an animal in the face is a pretty good sign that you could actually hurt that creature and might just sort of tip the balance in the pros and cons of that encounter for the shark.
The best spot to direct those punches is on the edge of the nose area where the shark's sensitive sensory organs are. Don't go for the eyes or the gills. And most attacks?
But we think it's a case of mistaken identity because we are not their prey, but we're in their environment.
And if you happen to come across one, that should I stay or should I go moment, don't move quickly by splashing or swimming. That mimics injured marine life, their natural prey. Stay calm, and if you're in shallow water, stand up, something their usual prey cannot do. But are the number of attacks actually increasing?
So far this year, there have been at least 25 shark attacks in the U.S.
An increase, but only slightly.
In 2021, during the peak of COVID, one of the only places people could go was to the beach. And so we saw a huge increase in the number of bathers at the beach, and therefore a larger number of shark encounters.
We've heard the deep science into why these attacks and encounters happen. Mistaken identity, curious sharks. But those who make their livelihood out on these waters say that there's no mistaking one way to avoid a close call with a shark. Stay away from their main food source. That means fish of all sizes. So if you see someone fishing off the beach, a boat, or a pier, keep walking before you head into the surf. In fact, Brevard Ocean Rescue tells us that lifeguards will alert swimmers if they see large schools of bait fish nearby, even before they spot sharks. In his more than 20 years as a fishing boat captain, Chris Cameron has seen plenty of sharks. On the reel and trying to eat what's on his reel.
Get hooked up, start reeling up, sharks. And sometimes you'll see the sharks come up, chomping as they come up their boat.
He's seen a wider variety of sharks and more of them.
Sure enough, you see one swim by. Oh, there's a shark. There's a shark. Then hopefully they're chewing that day. They're very finicky, so they're not man eaters. They don't just start eating everything.
And one thing to keep in mind, statistically, you're more likely to be killed during Black Friday shopping than a shark attack. On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.